Hey guys, today's video is about this car. I think it's a 2016 or 17 Lexus RX. It's just a service instruction. If you haven't done it before, this is gonna be step by step. I will do oil plus filter, cabin air filter, engine air filter, brake fluid change, give some tips here and there what to look for.
That's the stuff going in. It's the good Castrol Edge oil. This car takes 0W20. It's a full synthetic oil filter with the little nibble here. Seals. This is cabin air filter. This is the engine air filter. Yeah. Brake fluid, also brake fluid somewhere. Don't forget about it. Here it is. Once. Two. Probably just need 1.5. Yeah, start with the easy part. Cabin air filter. As long as we're clean. So, this is your cabin air filter. It's like any air filter. Only thing to look for is this one here. The airflow, right? By the way, your filter is down here usually. Open it.
You want to pull out this arm, right?
You have to squeeze this together and then pop it out. Just like that, right? Not a big deal. Now, up here, just push it out a little bit. Also on the other side, put it in. And now your glove box comes down. And go on right back here and use these little pushers. Take the lid off, right? Dampened, sound isolated. And this is your airbox, it says so. Not airbox, but this is. Okay, this is also taken care of. Just fell off. It is what it is. It says up to install it. All you do is you see on the left and on the right. I'm not to break them, just squeeze them together a little bit like this. And it comes out, right? Break it. Let's take a look if I broke it or not. These are the arms, it's all together. Nothing broke. Always be careful with these shit things. Or any time when you have to level some plastic. Shit can be very fragile. Here's the air filter. And it says up. So air filter out. So I just take this air filter out of here. Remember, don't flip this casing here. You don't know how it goes in. And here it says up, right? Would be nice if it says airflow. Just says up. If you look closer, you see all the dirt in here, right? Also the edge here. Right, you have to screen the edge. I would put airflow this way. It would be the other way around, right? So. Just by taking a look at the old filter, I would say that the dirt comes from the top. So the fresh air comes in from the top, right? So as long downwards, just make sure you have it somewhat latched in here. Up goes up. It's never done. All you do now is you take your glove box and make sure that these clip into these little pins. Lift it up with a push. Now it's in. Doesn't scrape or anything. It's all good. Lastly, take the brake dampener. Push it over there. Done. Then closes, opens, smooth. Done. And you put all the crap back in. That's how you change your cabin air filter. Changing a cabin air filter is something everybody can do, unless you have some limitations. But you've seen it. Next, just put on some gloves. And drop in the engine air filter, because that's still fairly easy. This is your engine over there, this is your airbox, right? Air comes in from here, snorkel, goes through here into the filter box, and here's the filter, we open it up in a second. The filtered air comes up, goes through this into your intake manifold, into the engine, that gets burned. This is easy, you just have these clips here, right? Open it up, this one here also. Hold it comes out and tada, your engine air filter.
More gloves equals more protection. You just lift it up a little bit, but careful. It's all tight. Just take it out, lift it up, fiddle it out. It's the engine air filter. It's the dirty side. It's not that dirty if you look at it, right? And again, it's not a desert. This car's not moved in a desert, but you can see particles in between here. You don't want that crap inside your engine, right? That's why you have that filter. New filter, what a surprise, it's the same thing. It's just about the particles in here. And you just dump it back in. Not careful to not limit anything. There is enough space to fill it in. It's not always easy, but it's designed so it can be filled. Right. Push here and it's in. Make sure it's evenly flat, it doesn't stick over. Just push the edge, hope you can see that, back in, right? Pop it down and just click back on. 1, 2, done. That's it, easy as that. Change the engine air filter. Next is the oil filter. So I'm gonna jack the car up first. And what we do then, right away, is whenever you change oil and you have one of these measure sticks, you wanna open it only for the reason so air can come into the engine here. And also your here engine oil filler cap. Oh, fuck. Piece of shit. You open this crap thing. Don't drop anything in there. I'm gonna lay the hood back down. You just open these two parts so air can go into the engine. Because once you open the outlet at the bottom, the oil will drain out and it will create a vacuum. It's a sealed system, right? And if it's sealed and you want something to come out, it's gonna create a vacuum. And then it just takes longer for the oil to come out. So just a little tip. Now I'm checking it up. So follow me under the car. We are looking for the oil filter. There it is. Supposedly sitting somewhere down here. There it is. On your front right side. This thing. This is your oil filter in there, right? This little, yeah, four piece weird looking plug. I think it's a half an inch. You open that and then supposedly nothing happens, and then you plug in this plastic piece and then the oil is supposed to start draining. But we will see about that. And then you have to open this entire thing and change the filter. Pretty simple as that. This here is the oil pan. Look at a different angle, you actually see that the filter is above the oil pan. This one here, the end, I open that one. That is an actual oil drain plug. And now just drain it from there and change this here without even bothering about it. Look at this, this just screams. This screams straight by me. Straight by me. So 14 millimeter. Yeah, shouldn't be too tight. Open oil catcher on standby, and you want to be careful. You want to push a little bit against it until it's loose, and then you take one leap just like that. As I promised, you get oil in your hands. Opening the oil filter, all right, good. Now you use this little pipe thing. Plug it in here. It's just draining the oil from the filter housing, right? So you don't open the filter and all this crap comes still out and flushes you. It's your oil filter, right? You open this flat square screw and plug in this little plastic piece that comes with the filter. Just opens the seal inside. And it bleeds out the filter housing. And the keys is in the other side.
the oil filler cap is open and the oil dipstick is open so air can come in. It just helps let it run out easily. Just use a simple extension to open this hole here on the oil filter housing. We put the two drain plugs back in and open the filter housing. For the filter housing, we need a special tool. This little thing here. And of course, there's no number on here, but it's a standard Toyota Lexus tool. You probably get it for 10 or 15 bucks on Amazon. One problem I had last time is that this should work on me. Because I don't have this is a 26 millimeter nut, I don't have that, but I just used the square inside, the probably half inch, and it could not take it well. It was just traced back that the shop that did it before I did it, tightened it too much, and then this entire cast piece just split in half. So today, I still don't have a 26 millimeter, but I have one of these, so I try to open it first and then put it back together and tighten it correctly. We'll tighten it with about 25 newton meter. Don't forget to replace the seal. The seal for this screw came off with this part. You put on a new one, then you're good to go. There it is. While snapping on the new sealing and going to find the screw. Shit fell off and now it's in here. The ceiling is still in there, but in my endless wisdom, I got two oil filters. I even have a second seal. I have to fish this one out later. This is your old oil filter inside. It's the old one, new one. You can spot the difference. And you have the seal here. Push it all the way in. Right, that's it.
And it goes right back in, just like that.
Push it a little bit, make sure it's straight, and you just close it. Tighten it with 25 millimeter or 20 pound feet of torque. You closed everything at the bottom. Now we just fill in some oil. This car, this engine, and the non-all-wheel drive, I guess, needs 5.8 quarts. It's about 5.5 liter. Pump in 5.5 quarts, maybe first. Start her up and see where the oil level stands. When measuring, you let it run first for a minute, then you let it cool for like 30 seconds, and then you measure, right? Oil is in. I also rescued this sealing ring. Flims it in. The light is white, you can see it's white in the middle. So we leave it like that. Once in a while you want to check on it, and that's it. You have a 40 millimeter nut at the bottom to drain the oil. We have a like an extension, like a half an inch square to open the relief from the oil filter housing. Then you have a special tool to open the housing. Get yourself a 26 millimeter nut. It's way too tight. You let it bleed, you close it, you change the seals and the filter, you close it again. You torque both with 25 newton meter or 20 foot pound. Give it some oil. Probably just put 5.5 quarts. It says 5.8 quarts, 5.5 liter. Maybe if you don't bleed long enough, then there is still some oil, some old oil in there. Then you end up having too much oil. Just check. Put 5 quarts, see where you are, start it up, let it settle, see where you are, and then add slowly quart by quart. This way you're on the safe side. All done, air filter done, cabin air filter done. And you start with the bleeding with the wheel or the brake that is furthest away from this. So this is all the way passenger side rear, right? Because this is the longest brake line. Then you go driver side rear, passenger side front, and last driver side front. You open it up, take the little hoodie off. As soon as Vivian gets back, I have her pump the brake, basically manually pumping it in, right? And then I just release it down at the bottom.
So what's gonna happen is she's gonna sit inside and just pump the brake slowly and steadily. At the same time, I will open the valve and let it run, let it bleed out. It's fairly simple. Honestly, nothing complicated about it. We start with topping off the container and then just pump it.
And you wanna prepare for mess. It's most likely you're gonna top it a bit.
So when I said it's gonna be easy, it's all it is for this Lexus. It's an 8mm.
Just take a tube, fits on there, it's snug. And of course you need a catch container. I don't have one right now. Just use an empty one of these. There you go. Feel now. Now just open it. And now it's open. Okay, pump please. And it's running out. It's dead easy.
Pump.
Back and forth, yeah. All the way through, and when you're at the bottom, you start new. It's not a race, but keep it going like this. Okay, you can see as she pumps when she gets off it. Wow, you see all the dirt coming out now? Ooh. And then we have the air coming out. So you just let it pump for a while, because this is the long line, right? You have the catch container. You wanna check on your container. Make sure it doesn't run empty. Looks pretty full. All these bubbles, that's what you want to get out of it, right? Usually a really old brake fluid is a dark yellow. So this is not too old, and like you see, this is almost the same color as the new one we filled in. Every time she gets off it, it just goes back. So that means when we close it, right, close the valve, then it's under pressure. Otherwise, it will suck in air and it will soften your brake pedal when you drive. So now she got it, now she's pumping well. Now he's also pumping it through the ABS system, as you can hear. Take a listen. And I've been refilling a couple times already with another sip. You have to keep topping it off to not run out of it. And I would say now we got enough. Now you can see stuff's coming out, and we're gonna close it now while she's not noticing it. So as soon as you close it, you will have pressure on the brake pedal again, and there's always some fluid running down here. Wear gloves. Brake fluid is an acid. Don't want to burn your hand. Trust me on this one. And now we go to the other side. You do not want to have air in your ABS unit, and if you do, you have to do all this again. Because air is compressible, fluid isn't. That's why you use brake fluid or brake gas. And we almost finished though. From here it's faster. Shouldn't take too long. You go to the front, now it starts to look cleaner. Have a few little bubbles in here. There's one coming out. Just that one at the rear, you do the front ones. The front ones are faster because the line is shorter. At the end, you want to clean the brake fluid off here. Just take some brake cleaner. It is an acid, it will corrode your brake saddle. And you put the dust cap on it. And that's it. And then slap the wheels on, take it for a test drive, and it's finished. That's all. This is how you change your oil, your air filter, your cabin air filter, your brake fluid at home in your own garage, because it's not that complicated, as I believe you might agree. That's it. Make just sure you top off the brake fluid at the end,
It doesn't have to be all the way to the top because the brakes are not new. Once you change the brake pads, you'll have to push the pistons back and then it comes out on the top. You top it off, almost max. Close it, you're good.
You also want to maybe top off your windshield wiper fluid. You want to check your coolant level, right? Brake fluid, we just topped it off, already topped it off. All the work is done. Last two things. First, turn on the ignition on two. For now, we set this one, the oil maintenance, and let's see what else it has. Maintenance with Adelina. First, you push it away here in the back. You clear the menu. You use the arrow buttons to cycle through. You see how it changes. You go to this settings wheel. You go vehicle settings and you confirm with the button in the middle. Pop. And we do scheduled maintenance. So do oil maintenance. It says, it just tells you what to reset. Yes. Yes, zack. We did that. We reset it. Good. It's also been scheduled maintenance. Both together this time. This is how you reset your maintenance. Vehicle settings. Scheduled maintenance. Reset data, yes. That's been resetted, seen it. Oil maintenance, yes. It's been resetted. And now it did take it 9,999 miles, right? That's what you want. Just have to adjust the air pressure. First you check which size it is. 235, 65, 18. You'll find a little sticker. Usually it's in here. 235, 65, 18, 33, 33 all around. And don't forget the spare. And put more pressure on the spare because the one time you need it, it usually doesn't have any pressure on it anyway.
Thanks for watching. See you next time.